Dear students, I welcome you all in the RKGIT e-learning channel. I, Dr. Pawan Kumar Shukla, I am Professor in Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, RKGIT. Today, I am going to deliver a video lecture on microwave engineering. Actually, this is a very interesting subject, and to know the basic concepts, the fundamentals about this microwave engineering, it is very necessary to know about the facts behind the electromagnetic spectrum. Because if we define the microwave, actually microwave is a range of frequencies which are very higher in the electromagnetic spectrum. When we are starting the studies of communication, then we firstly discuss the radio band, which is only limited up to 300 megahertz. After that, when we are going upward and upward in the frequency range of electromagnetic spectrum, we see that a large range of frequencies can be utilized for the communication purposes, for the device manufacturing and fabrication purposes, and different high frequency applications are used nowadays in microwaves. Actually, microwave is that specific band of this whole spectrum which is mostly utilized for the different satellite communications, different radar communications, different television communications, and different mobile communications. Generally, all the modern type of communications are utilizing the microwave frequencies. So, firstly, we discuss about the radio band. Actually, this band is limited up to 300 megahertz. All the low frequency range applications are comprising within the different bands of radio band. Actually, this radio band can be configured under the category of VLF, LF, MF, HF, VHF and so on. When the radio band's highest spectrum means we can say up to 300 megahertz, it is characterized only by VHF. After that, when ultra high frequency band is starting from 300 megahertz, actually microwave band comes into existence. And after that, microwave band is reaching up to 300 gigahertz. And this particular band is specified for large number of applications. And these large number of applications, as I have discussed previously, means satellite communication, radar communication, mobile communication, and so much number of applications. Generally, if we are talking about the complete electromagnetic spectrum, after that, after the microwave band, it is not limited up to 300 gigahertz only. If we see this electromagnetic spectrum reaching towards multiples and a large number of frequencies which are not limited till now, and they are reaching to the point where we can say the infinity, where the invention has been not carried out yet, but the things are going on. The first band after the microwave, it is infrared band. This is 300 gigahertz to 375 into 10 to the power 3 gigahertz. Visible, this visible spectrum is a very specified spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum, because it utilizes all those wavelengths which can be used for the optical communication purposes. And it is a very small band which is generally the light waves, or you may say that all the visible lights which can be generated by the LEDs or laser lights, and these lights can be used for the optical communication. So this particular band, visible band, is specified for optical communication. After that, ultraviolet, X-rays, gamma rays, cosmic rays. If we generally consider all these waves, basically somehow these waves, these rays are very harmful for human livings, but nowadays telecommunication is reaching towards that point of technicalities where we can utilize these frequencies too for the purpose of communication. So anyway, because we are talking about the microwave engineering, so we will definitely discuss the different bands of microwave frequency range of electromagnetic spectrum. Now come to the point on which we will discuss the different microwave bands frequency wise and its applications. Now we will discuss specifically the microwave bands. Actually, in the whole spectrum, we categorize the microwave frequency range from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. But for the communication point of view and for different specific applications in microwaves, generally we consider this UHF band as ultra high frequency band from 300 megahertz to 1 gigahertz. Means within this range of frequencies, they cannot be much utilized for the microwave specific applications. They are starting from 1 gigahertz. So under the consideration of IEEE or IET from US military and different other organizations and institutions of telecommunication provide the different structure of microwave bands. Actually, these different bands are specified in terms of these letters like L band, S band, C band, X band, KU band, K band, KA band, V band, W band, and all the other microwave frequencies are coming in the category of millimeter and submillimeter waves. So I just want to give you the brief introduction of all these bands and how many applications in these frequency range can be used for nowadays so higher level telecommunications. Just starting from the L band. Actually, the range of this L band microwave frequency, it is 1 gigahertz to 2 gigahertz. And the different applications which are mostly utilized within this band are GSM, Global System for Mobile Communication, GPS, Global Positioning System. And if we talk about the other applications within this band, we can say that digital audio broadcasting is a very special feature for this L band. Submarine and the marine navigational, different things, different types of communications can be linked within this band. So L band is also specified on those applications where sea surface or water surface or ship or harbor telephony or such type of satellite and navigational communication links can be set up by using the band of L within the range of 1 to 2 gigahertz. The other band is S band, 2 to 4 gigahertz. And this particular frequency range is very much specified for different applications, and all these applications are very much familiar to normal human being, for the normal society, for the normal social norm. Different things, like if we discuss the 2 to 4 gigahertz frequency range in microwave, generally it is used for the low power unlicensed microwave devices. And if we discuss the different devices and components which we can use, they are like wireless headphones, like Bluetooth devices, like Wi-Fi, and very important thing, microwave oven. Generally, this microwave oven is also used within this range of S band. It is used within the frequency range of 2.42 gigahertz. Zigbee, this is also a very particular example of microwave S band. So there are large number of applications which can be specified under the category of S band. The next band is C band. Actually, this C band of microwave frequency range is specifically used for the full time satellite communication. Generally, we use satellite TV in this frequency range, different long distance communication devices and equipments are also fabricated under this frequency range. After that, X band is especially designed for the laboratory purposes or experimental purposes. So all the laboratory equipments and the components are designed within the band. X band, it is 8 to 12 gigahertz. Generally in civil purposes and military purposes, this is also utilized. Somehow some radar applications are also used in the X band. Generally in defense services, this X band is very popular and very particular for manufacturing the different defense equipments. KU band, 12 to 18 gigahertz. Actually, this band is also utilized for satellite communication as well as radar communication. But the specific application of this band is VSAT, very small aperture terminals. Generally, on the ships or when we are using the water defense services, then these VSAT systems can be installed on the aeroplane or ships or any other point where such type of satellite communication links may be designed and manufactured for that specific purposes. K band, 18 to 27 gigahertz, it is specifically used for some those radar applications where the astronomical observations are taking care, and these astronomical observations are used for the weather forecasting and different other types of satellite communications. K band, it is specified for 27 to 40 gigahertz, and this is used for wideband applications in microwave engineering. Actually, in microwave engineering, after the K band means 27 gigahertz to 40 gigahertz, these specified bands are finished. So after 40 gigahertz, there is a wide range of 40 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz, which is not specified in terms of a single band. It is defined in terms of millimeter and submillimeter waves. And the description of these millimeter waves and submillimeter waves, it is a very wide, vast topic for the research and experiments purposes. Generally, these frequencies are also categorized in V band and W band. And these V band and W band are using a very high range of frequencies in microwave in terms of extraterrestrial communications and different experimental setups. If we specify millimeter and submillimeter waves, generally different defense organizations like DRDO, ISRO, NASA, these organizations are using such frequencies and such range of frequencies of microwaves for their purposes. And the overall setup of microwave frequencies is constrained within the government applications. And this is the whole spectrum of microwave frequencies which are carrying a large number of very interesting applications. So, because this is my first basic conceptual lecture on microwave engineering, so I want to create a general awareness and the different application part for this microwave engineering subject. I wish good luck. Thank you very much.